Well, thanks so much, mate, and thank you for... On the incident that we have reported on, we have made very strong representations at every level to China about this incident, which we regard as unprofessional and unacceptable. Australian Defence Force personnel were going about their job in international waters, but also in international skies, to support the United Nations in the sanctions that they have against the North Korean regime. That is part of Australia being good global citizens. And Australian Defence Force personnel should not be at risk whilst they're doing that. So we have a very clear position there. We do have communications with China. That includes visits, and the Chinese Premier will be here in June. We will make our position clear as well in discussions as we do. One of the things that had broken down over a period of time was any dialogue. Dialogue is important. It's always, always important to have avenues of communication. And that's why we've used all of those avenues of communication to make our position on this incident very clear. We have raised it with Beijing, and we always raise areas of agreement and also areas of disagreement when we have that dialogue.
Thanks
very much.
Thank you.事实真相是，澳方的军舰机打着执行联合国安理会决议的旗号，蓄意抵近中国的领空，滋事挑衅，危害中方的海空安全。出于警告提醒目的，中国军队在现场采取了必要的处置措施，相关的操作合法合规，专业安全。 中方已就澳方有关冒险做法提出严正交涉，敦促澳方立即停止挑衅和炒作，避免引发误解误判。